Hi children, so today's class will be continuity of chapter 5, exercise 3. So under exercise 3, we are going to see how to compare the given fractions. So comparing fractions has two way, like two way of comparison will be there. Like one is a like fraction, that is comparing like fractions, and comparing unlike fractions. Okay, so like fraction means you have this like and unlike fractions. What is this like and unlike fractions? You have already learnt in 4th standard. So I'll just give a small hint. So like fraction means the fraction which has the denominator same. Denominator same. So whichever fractions, two fractions or more than two fractions, all the denominators will be same. When you have all the denominators of the fractions are same, you will treat it as a like fraction. So when comes to unlike fraction, so when the fractions two or more fractions are given to you, when all the denominators are different, when all the denominators are different, you will treat it as an unlike fraction. Okay, so for example, I'm taking two fractions to show you. First, we'll just see how to compare the like fraction. So I told you like fraction in the sense the given fractions will have the denominator same. So when your denominators are same, if you see 3 by 4, 2 by 4. So these two denominators are same. So when you are comparing the like fractions, when denominators are same, you can just compare the numerator and you can come to a conclusion whether which is bigger and which is smaller. So in numerator, 3 is greater than 2. So I'm directly concluding that 3 by 4 is greater than 2 by 4. Okay, just in one step it will be completed when you compare the like fraction. So I'll just show you one more example for this like fraction. 50 by 60, 30 by 60. So if you see, the denominators are same. 60, 60. So when the denominators are same, you can just compare the numerator whether which is big and which is small. So 50 is greater than 30. So this 50 is greater than 33. I'm concluding 50 by 60 fraction is greater than the 33 by 60 fraction. Okay, so this comparing like fraction will be very simple. Then I'll just move on to the comparing unlike fractions. So I said you unlike fractions means denominators with the given fractions will be different. Okay, so comparing unlike fractions has two concepts. That two concepts in the sense two way of unlike fractions are there. The first thing I've shown you, 2 by 5, 2 by 7. 2 by 5 and 2 by 7. So if you see the denominators are same or different? The denominators are different. So when you have the denominators are different, it is absolutely unlike fraction. Okay. So, since now it is considered as, it is an unlike fraction, now compare the numerator. See, in the numerator, both the values are same. Here, with another example of unlike fraction, compare the denominator. 4, 5. Since the denominators are different, it is also considered as an unlike fraction. But if you see in the numerator, it is 3 and 2. So, but here the numerators are same. Here the numerators are also different. Denominators and numerators are different. But here denominators are different, but the numerators are same. But both the fractions of which have given you are the unlike fraction. Whenever, wherever your denominators are different, it is absolutely an unlike fraction. But when after finding it is an unlike fraction, you have to check whether the numerator are same or not. Okay. So first I'll just tell you when unlike fraction has numerator same. When unlike fractions have numerator same. How to compare? Okay, so I've given the same value of fraction 2 by 5 and 2 by 7. So here 5, 7 denominators are different. It is an unlike fraction. But the numerators are same. So when you have this kind of unlike fraction, you can compare the denominators. Listen carefully. Compare the denominators. Whichever denominator has the least value, that fraction is greater. That is 2 by 5, 2 by 7. So here compare the denominator 5, 7. So 7 is greater, 5 is smaller than this 7. So whichever denominator value is smaller, that whole fraction is considered as greater. Understood? Understood? See, here in like fraction, when the denominators are same, you will compare the numerator. Whichever is greater, that is considered as greater fraction. But here, the denominators are different, but the numerators are same. When you have the numerators are same in unlike fraction, you can compare the denominator value. Whichever value is smaller, that complete fraction, the whole fraction is treated as greater value. I'll show you in with a picture. See, if you see, I have given two similar boxes with the same length. Okay, so here the first box I have split it into 5 equal parts. See, the box I have split it into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I have split it into 5 equal parts, which is your denominator is 5. And here 2 by 5, no, that only I have denoted here. So the denominator 5, numerator is 2. That is, I have to shade the 2 boxes, which is 2 by 5. So next is 2 by 7. So the one whole box with the same length, I have divided into 7 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the denominator is 7. So how many parts I should shade? 2. So if you compare this shaded part and this shaded part, you see the boxes are with the same length. The boxes are with the same length, but it is divided into different parts. One is 5 and one is 7. But the shaded part is 2 only. Equally, it is shaded 2 boxes only. But if you see the length of the shaded part, this 2 by 5 has greater space and this 2 by 7 has a lesser space. So obviously, this 2 by 5 is greater than this 2 by 7. So that is what we have directly said here. I have directly said here. Understood? So now I'll just move on with this second concept. So when you have both numerator and denominator are different, how to compare in an unlike fraction? So here I've just given the same fraction 3 by 4 and 2 by 5. So whenever you have both numerator and denominator are different in an unlike fraction, first you have to change them into like fraction. So why we are changing into like fraction? When we change into like fraction, the denominators will become same. When the denominators are same, it will be very easy for you to compare the numerator and say which is bigger and which is smaller. So that is why we are changing the unlike fraction. This is unlike fraction, no? Unlike fraction. We are changing into like fraction. So to change to like fraction, we have two methods, which will be followed: equivalent fraction and LCM method. So these two methods are there to convert into like fraction. You can use any one method. It is not that this method only you have to use. Just learn with the two methods. Whichever method is comfortable for you, you can use any method in this equivalent fraction and LCM method. Okay. So I am just going to show you with the first method, which is equivalent method. 3 3 by 4 and 2 by 5, the same number fraction I've given. So here equivalent fraction I'm going to find with the 3 by 4. See how to find this equivalent fraction. I've showed you in the first exercise. No, the given fraction has to be multiplied with 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. So this is how you will find the equivalent fraction. 3 2s are 6, 4 2s are 8. 3 3s are 9, 4 3s are 12. 3 4s are 12, 4 4s are 16. 5 3s are 15, 5 5s are 25. Okay? So this 5 4s are 20. It's actually 3 by 4. No, the question is. So this equivalent fraction, I have to write it here. 6 by 8, 9 by 12, 12 by 16, 15 by 20. The same how you found the equivalent fraction for 3 by 4, the same how you have to find out. So I am here going to give direct equivalent fraction. So 2 by 5, then 4 by 10, that is 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 6 are 12. So 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 30. Okay. So now, after finding the equivalent fractions for both the fractions, compare the denominators of all the equivalent fraction. Whichever denominators are same, just round out that. 8, do you have any denominator 8? No. 12, any denominator 12? No. 16, any denominator as 16? No. 20, any denominator as 20? Yes. So we have same denominator with the value 20. 15 by 20 and 8 by 20. Okay, so this 15 by 20 I am writing here and 8 by 20. So now, these two fractions have become like fraction. Yes? So now the denominators are same. Now the denominators are same. I have written the same. 15 by 20, 8 by 20. So now since it is both the denominators are same, it is considered as a like fraction. Now you can compare the numerator 15, 8. So 15 is obviously greater than 8. So 15 by 20 is greater than 8 by 20. So what is this exactly? 15 by 20 is equivalent to 3 by 4. 3 by 4. This 8 by 20 is equivalent to 2 by 5. So obviously when 15 by 20 is equal means 15 by 20 is greater than 8 by 20 means 3 by 4 is also greater than 2 by 5. So this is how you have to make use of this first method, equivalent fraction method. So first you have to find the equivalent fractions of given two fractions. Just a minimum 5 or 6. 5 or 6 equivalent fraction you can find. And then you can compare with the denominators. Whichever denominator you have similar with the same value, you can just circle that and you can just compare with that equivalent fraction and you can come to a conclusion which is bigger and which is smaller. So we'll just see the second method of LCM method in the next video. Thank you, children.